Thanks, Lord. Bienvenida, Wang Ying, M. Fong, willkommen. We are delighted to see you. And we pray that our service this morning will be a blessing to your life, a warm welcome to visitors and newcomers, and we invite you to sign the guest book located in the lobby at the back there in the narthex outside the sanctuary doors. My name, oh yes, that's where I'm supposed to say it here. My name is Gail Enright. I recently was given a surgical date for my hip replacement, September 13th. And it's not a Friday! Anyway, I wanted to thank everyone who has been praying for me for the past year, or since I've been here, for my surgery that would really happen. Now, please don't stop praying. I'm hoping that everything will go well and I'll have no complications after the surgery. Is. Anyway, I wanted to tell you that I have moved here from Prince Albert this last June. I closed my French daycare 35 years. I'm bilingual in French only. But I wanted to let you know I did sell my home in 4 days. And I'm really enjoying the condo I'm renting here in Saskatoon. I have 3 adult children that live here in Saskatoon. Gavard, Jean-Marc, and Gaetan, they're French too. Anyway, and I have one daughter, Annette, Mon Ange, Chloe. I have 6 grandchildren, and I'm soon to be officially divorced. New beginnings! New beginnings. Now, I came to Knox on the advice of my ministers in Prince Albert, Nora Vedras, and Tony Thompson, both knew Kent. And they said he could probably handle you, Gail. And I said, good advice. I came here seeking fellowship and community. And I have found it here. Thank you. Now, I'm not so sure why you have come to worship at Knox on such a beautiful, glorious day today. Is it habit? Are you part of a community? Have you not had a chance to catch up with your friends and you thought you'd just meet here? Oh, and if you're visiting, were you driving by and you're curious what the inside of that church might look like? Now, I'm not sure about this, but perhaps you need a safe place to catch a few winks. Seeking peace? Well, for whatever reason you are here today, hopefully you will leave this place having found that which you seek today in your life. Now, I have some announcements, and they're printed here for me, which is very handy. First off, I'm supposed to say a hearty thank you to the wonderful volunteers who came out on August 22nd to assist in cleaning the kitchen. I've heard that it was really in need of a good cleaning because, you know, that COVID thing. Anyway, the kitchen looks brand new. It was a huge task, but it was a complete success. Next, there's the last call for Broadview subscription renewals. If you want to renew, or please make your check. If you want to renew, If you want to renew, please make your check out to Knox United Church for $30. You can place it in the offering plate, or you can bring it to the Knox office before August the 30th. Candlelight concerts, have you seen that announcement on, I saw it on Facebook and I thought, what a great idea. This church would look lovely by candlelight, I'm sure, and I'm gonna come. Anyway, the concert at Knox is on September 6th and 7th for 2 performances per evening. And ticket information, pricing can be found on our website at www.feverup.com. Anyway, there's one pasted on here. St. David's Trinity United Church is celebrating 60 years on September the 10th. You can join them from 12 o'clock until 4 o'clock p.m. for family fun, food, and fellowship. They're celebrating 60 years. Now, I'm going to ask you, is anybody out there celebrating a special birthday, perhaps? Or even a birthday? They're all special. Do we have anybody that's had a birthday in the last week or one coming up? Aha! You're off the hook. Almost. What about anniversaries? Any anniversaries? No? So there you go. What have you got coming up?
My sister.
Oh, that's not October. Oh, that's a little. Okay, but you know, it's coming. It's coming. Now we've gone through that. Are there any other announcements? Oh, good. I can have some water now.
I have received a text from Allison. Her and Marcel are still at the lake. Anyway, Allison realized, oh my goodness, August is just about done, and she hadn't gotten any lay reading bulletin up to sign up for lay reading in September. So she asked me if I would sign up. Get a piece of paper out. So I do. It's at the back of the sanctuary. It's attached to a blue, what do you want to call it? Blue. It's like it's click, 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 clipboard. And I do have a pen attached to it. So I have to put my name down for the first Sunday, September 3rd. So we need the 10th, 17th, and 24th. So if you're available in one of those Sundays to sign up for a lay reader, we'd really appreciate it.
Thank you for that. It's really not all that bad, you know. You have sort of a captive on. No, they're not really. And if anybody needs to leave for any reason, it's okay. Like if you need the bathroom, for instance, it's downstairs on the next level down. And two levels down. Oh yeah, right. Because the next level down is just the entrance, and then you have to go down more. But if there's too many stairs, there's an elevator just over. I mean, through there, and anyway, you can find it. I'm sure. Okay, now we've gone through that. So far, so good. What I really wanted to announce, too, is that we have a lovely family sharing their musical talents with us today. And we've already heard some of them, I mean, talents. Heather on the piano. And then we have Lloyd, I'm assuming you're Lloyd the father, and we have listened to Lachlan already, and he's helped us with the candle. Good job. I have found the music to be wonderful here at Knox each week, and it's a very nice variety. It's a great thing to have that we can share. Now, okay. Before we get started, I just wanted to make a note that as we gather for worship today, we acknowledge with deep gratitude that the land on which we gather is Treaty 6 territory, the ancestral land of several Indigenous nations and part of the homeland of the Métis. We respect the sacredness of our shared home and the ground on which we walk, and we are grateful for its stewardship through the centuries. Please join me in the call to worship with the congregation. Finally, you get to put your word in here. The congregation, would you please read the words responsively in the bold print, as printed in your bulletin. We come this day carrying joys and sorrows. We come this day from a world that can be judgmental and harsh. We come this day seeking guidance and strength.
Open our hearts to
have come this day to worship.
Good job.
That is very, very, very well done. So we're going to continue on. Doing the same thing. Prayer of approach. Loving God, you live in us through the Spirit. Give us the courage and the strength today to follow Christ, to let the Spirit guide our lives. Through your love, O God, all is possible.
Amen.
Who are maybe new to the congregation, or just visiting,
Anyone want to say hi? I'm going to keep blowing bubbles. Anybody? Welcome. Do you want to introduce this to your grandma and grandpa?
This is my grandma.
Hi, Graham. And your grandpa? We're so glad that you're here. And you're from
Sudbury.
All those Ontario places, they're very confusing. It's great to see you. Anybody else visiting or new to the congregation this week? No. Well, that's all right. It's great to have you all back. Can we please take as long as it takes to stand, share the peace of Christ with those around us and across the room or wherever we need to go. May the peace of Christ be with you all. That as we prepare to sing the hymn of illumination, it's dicey, which is perfect. All worship is dicey at the best of times, I think. So as we prepare, we recognize that the Word of God comes to us in bubbles. It comes to us in children, it comes to us in song, and it comes to us in the Word of Scripture. So let us prepare to hear the Word of Scripture. Singing first, open our hearts.
Each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we, who are many, are one body in Christ. And individually, we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy, in proportion to faith. Ministry, in ministering. The teacher, in teaching. The encourager, in encouragement. The giver, in sincerity. The leader, in diligence. The compassionate, in cheerfulness. Our next reading is from Matthew 16, verses 13 to 20. Peter's declaration about Jesus. Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others say Elijah, and still others, Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah. God bless to our understanding these words of Scripture. Amen. Now we're going to have our special music. Thank you.
Around our house, we've recently discovered a podcast that I've just learned about from our last road trip. The podcast is called Snoop and Sniffy. Now, Snoop and Sniffy are dog detectives. What that means is they are the best dog detectives in the city because they're the only dog detectives in the city. So Snoop and Sniffy, I got that right. Snoop and Sniffy have all sorts of adventures to solve crimes or solve problems anyway. Now the interesting thing with Snoop and Sniffy is they live with humans, but the humans that they live with are called the Schlub family. The implication is that humans are just a bunch of schlubs. The dogs are the ones who know things, and humans just schlubbing around. Now, I bring up the word schlub because that's often the way I consider myself in terms of faith, in terms of the world. We're just trying to schlub our way through it. Today, we get to read in Scripture about Peter. Peter is one of my favorite disciples because Peter is a faithful, wonderful schlub. You remember a couple of weeks ago, Peter was the person who stepped out of the boat when Jesus was walking across the water, and Peter took a couple of steps because he was feeling the faith. He felt pretty good. He took a couple of steps across the water, and then he panicked, and he started to sink like a rock. Oh, Peter the schlub. Now, Peter, sadly, was also the person who was terrified when Jesus was crucified. And the next morning, Peter quite understandably denied that he even knew who Jesus was. 3 times he did that, and he felt like a schlub. Peter is human, and that's what makes him approachable for all of us. Because we have all been able to put ourselves in those sorts of situations where we are just doing our best. At the core, we're kind of schlubs. But you know the amazing thing about Peter is Jesus, in this scripture reading, proclaims that, Peter, you are the rock on which I'm going to build the church. And all of us look at this and say, Peter, this guy, this is the guy that's going to be the foundation for the entire church. This guy's just a schlub like the rest of us. And that's the point. Jesus asks Peter, it's okay. What were you going to ask about?
Is it what I believe the podcast is, or called Snoopy?
No, it's not Snoop. It's not Snoopy podcast. It's Snoop and Sniffy. You got to check it out. You're going to love it. It's got some great stuff to it. Now, Jesus asks Peter. Peter, the person who is going to be the rock, the source of the church, the foundation of the church, he asks, Peter, who do you say that I am? And for all those of us who are here in this church today, who are part of this faith community, we have the exact same question asked to us every time. Is there a greater question for people of faith than, who do you say that I am, from Jesus? Now, our temptation oftentimes when we are asked that or when we think about it is, who is Jesus to me? We sort of make it personal. We make it about a personal relationship with Jesus. We want to value the sharing of our own understanding, of our own story. And oftentimes we can even talk about it in terms of a personal testimony, in terms of a faith experience we've had. And there's a lot of value to that. Sometimes we can talk about sort of a personal salvation time. We can talk about personal struggles and growth that we've experienced in our faith and how Jesus has supported us through that with health struggles and challenges. We can celebrate and acknowledge the vital importance of emotional and spiritual well-being that has come through our experience of Christ. Who do you say that I am? For many of us, Jesus has been a source of personal healing, of love, of kindness, of hope. A warm embrace on the cool, dark nights of the soul. That's valuable. That's important. The challenge that Paul recognizes is that it can be a problem if that's where it ends. If our only relationship with Jesus is personal, if we can only speak about our own personal interaction, our own personal rewards,
then we're missing a great deal of our relationship depth. There's a story of a Jesuit priest who was meeting with a group of pastors in the United States. They began their gathering by asking him, "Brother, are you saved?" And the Jesuit priest responded, "My friends, not yet, but God is working on it." We're all working on it. This salvation idea that somehow we are saved or not saved can be so limiting in terms of our understanding of faith. We can recognize that we are all a work in progress. And Paul reminds us that. He reminds us that the connection to a personal Christ is only one step. There's a lot of work to do that has to happen after that. He says, "I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, I appeal to you. Remember that we are part of something much larger in Christ. We are a family. We are a team. We are strengthened by our diversity. We are strengthened by the incredible, varied experiences of faith and the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. As in one body," he says, "we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. We who are many are one body in Christ. And individually, we are members one of another. We look to each other to discover more and more about who we believe that Jesus is." Now, Lindsay, in her church in Delisle and Vanscoy, finishes every service with a similar benediction, and she uses these words. She reminds the congregation that you belong to God. We belong to each other. You do not walk alone. You belong to God. We belong to each other. You do not walk alone. So who do you say that I am? The United Church of Canada, last year, at their General Council, so what that is sort of the national meeting of the entire United Church of Canada, chose this scripture as their theme passage. It talked about a church that is connected, asking, what is God's purpose for us? Who do you say that I am? Why did Jesus choose a bunch of schmucks like us as the foundation of this ministry to the most vulnerable people in the world? Perhaps he did it because the world is crying out for us to keep working, to keep trying, to keep growing. The world needs the people of God to reveal who Christ is. Social gospel, good news of Jesus, of justice and peace, hope for compassion. We know that we speak volumes by our actions as the body of Christ. Paul says, "Together we are transformed by the renewing of the mind, discerning what is the will of God." Now, our friend Jay, who's not here this morning, Jay is a songwriter and artist, musician, and he has a song called Gospel. And I've asked his permission to use the song sometime, but I'm not going to use it now when he's not here. But Jay's song Gospel speaks of images of people experiencing addiction, homelessness, and it includes a call to love. Jay writes, "Put your hard hat on and go to work. Not speaking to the people of addictions, but speaking to those of us who care for people experiencing addictions. For those of us who are caring for those going through difficult times," he says, "put your hard hat on and go to work. It is what it is, and it ain't no more." He reminds us Jesus hung out with the leper and the whore. Keep on knocking, and it'll open the door. In the coming months, my friends, we're going to be asking ourselves, as a community of faith, and as individuals, who do we say that Christ is? Here in Saskatoon, who do we say that Christ is? As the United Church of Canada, who do we say that Christ is? Now, often here at Knox, I've heard it said from many people who visit, and those who have been here for years, Knox feels like home, which is a beautiful statement. I think we might have to stick that on our website. Home is comfort. Home is acceptance. It is safety. It is love. That's part of the reason we're a part of this community. But we also ask what else brings us here, in body and in spirit. Because we don't want this to be a transactional experience relationship with Jesus. We don't want to come here because it is good for us. Because it's renewal and it's peace. All the gifts that we receive from home, those are good things. But it's not all of it. I don't know what your home was like growing up, but my house had chores. We had a chore list right beside the kitchen window. And that was part of home. It's a reminder of the gift of our discipleship. That God has a chore list as part of our home. Sometimes that's why I need to be part of the faith community. I need to be reminded of the chore list that comes with being home. To be shared with a whole bunch of other schlubs like me. So we bring our personal gifts, the aspects of ourselves, all those individual things that Paul talks about, the prophetic voices, the teaching and the caring and the healing and the encouragement and the building up and the leadership. And you know what he finishes off with? He finishes off with cheerfulness. For those of us who can be cheerful, let's share that as much as we can. Bring them together to contribute to a shared vision of God's world. A vision that is committed to changing the world. Now, nobody knows what that looks like, but it starts with a heartfelt belief that something's possible. In the face of all the anger and all the injustice and all the violence that's in this world, there's a place where each of us can find that spot where our passions meet the world's need. Friends, we speak volumes by the actions that we take as the body of Christ. So the question that we need to think about, consider, and pray over is, what do we reveal? What do we show? What do we make clear about the Spirit of Christ? How will the world be renewed by our actions? How will Christ be seen in us? There's a question for us to leave with. God bless. To your visions and to your hopes and to your dreams and to your discipleship, all of the actions that lay ahead of us this week. Amen. Next hymn, Heather, before we sing the next hymn, I have to ask you, were you going to play something during the collection, the offering? Perfect. Okay, I that's all good. I just wanted to make sure that we didn't miss anything with Lachlan, for sure. What we're going to do is we'll gather to sing together number 703 in Voices United. In the ball there is a flower. 703.
Thank you.
to the grace of God, we collect our offering, and we give thanks for the music of Lachlan and Heather. For the leadership within this congregation, within this community, for the people who have offered lay leadership, for the people who have offered musical leadership, for those who have offered the leadership of hospitality in welcoming people to our community, we give thanks. We also know that the world needs our prayer and our support in so many places. We continue our prayers for those here in our own country, in BC and Northwest Territory, who face evacuations, who have suffered loss of home, property, those who have suffered injury and even death. We pray for the firefighters, the protection and law enforcement people who are helping us face these challenges. We pray also for the devastation that's happened to creation, the loss of wildlife and habitat, the changes and the extreme impacts that go beyond the natural cycles of life and rebirth here in your creation. We also give thanks and offer gratitude for those who've been able to return safely. May they know that they are supported. May they know that they also have a chance to share support with others. In a world of violence, God, we pray for peace. We offer a prayer for those impacted by gun violence in Jacksonville, United States. Racism, hatred, self-righteous rage have no place in your world, God. Help us to find healing in response to violence. Help us to seek peace. Peace of action, peace of love, peace of language, peace of respectful relationship with one another. At this time of year in our province, we pray for those who are in the agricultural industry as they face harvest and prepare to bring the fields . We also pray for those leaders in our world and in our country, local, provincial, and federal, who make decisions that sometimes forget to care for the vulnerable. Sometimes we forget to listen to the voices of real children. Sometimes we forget to consult and work with the professionals who care for them. We pray for wisdom, God. We pray for hope. We pray for justice. All of these prayers, God, we bring before you, along with the prayers of our hearts. You know the names of those who we hold deepest in our minds and in our love. Care for them, watch over them. Guide us as we seek to be the people that you would have us be. In the name of Christ, in the vision of Christ, and in the footsteps of Christ, we pray, saying the words that he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My friends, our closing hymn this morning is number 649 in Voices United, Walk With Me.
Oh,
friends.
As in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. We, who are many, are one body in Christ. And individually, we are members one of another. You belong to God. We belong to each other. You do not walk alone. And the blessing of bubbles is very important for all of us. Remember, as these bubbles cascade upon you, let her rip, team. Oh, yeah. These bubbles are a symbol of each of us. The color within them represents each of us gathered here. They are fragile, they can be damaged very quickly, but they're also restored by the breath of God. So may the blessing of the bubbles, the blessing of the Spirit of God, go with you all as you remember. You belong to God, we belong to each other, and you do not walk alone. Amen.